No Film School's coverage of NAB is brought to you by Big Stock, videos and images for everyone. Color Grading Central, professional color grading with color finale. Shutterstock, where ideas take shape. Black Magic Design, amazing solutions for film, post-production, and television.
Okay, so I'm here with Brian at the Redrock booth, and here we're looking at the HĀLO.
Yes.
It's brand new this year.
Brand new. This is something we've been working on, I think, for about 3 years now. I call it our avatar project. It took 5 years for the technology to catch up to the point so we could actually show you what we're about to show you today. So the problem that we're trying to solve has to do with dynamic focus control. And we're trying to solve it in a kind of a very specific way, that there's a range of people who actually use this, anywhere from an individual operator or maybe an enthusiast or an amateur who's just like, look, handle the focus for me, all the way up to professionals who are like, look, I know how to pull focus. I just need a better system and better references to do that. And there's a whole bunch of gray in between. Like, how do we actually do this? Some combination of automatic and manual focus. And that's really what we tried to do with HĀLO. So I'm going to go ahead and give you a demonstration right now. This is the first part of the HĀLO system. This is our remote focus interface. You can see it's a combination of hardware and a beautiful software display and interface. It's a three-channel system. I've got zoom. I can see I can have my iris system here. And then this is, of course, my focus. So just purely from a, I want to have a better remote focus experience, you can see that I have information about where I'm focused. It actually gives me a really nice electronic distance marker. And it actually, in the lens that I put in here, will show me the angle of view so I can actually see what's in the shot and what's not. And as I move my focusing, you can see that it's actually calculating the depth of field in real time. It will actually show me kind of what's in focus and what's not. So as a reference tool, first of all, it's a lot prettier, and second of all, it's a lot more useful in terms of the information it has.
Now, is that something you have to set in terms of the lens that's on there? You'll type in which lens is actually on the camera?
Yeah, so you'd either enter in the lenses in, like typically during a prep, or we envision in the future you'll be able to just plug in those lenses that have that automatic information. We'll pull it directly from the lens itself. So here's where it gets really interesting. So there's a device in the front here. It's called the HĀLO Explorer. This is a technology that is the same as using autonomous cars for collision detection and avoidance. So it's a real-time system. You can tell it's being incredibly responsive. And most importantly, it doesn't require any setup or special technology. When you get in a car, you don't say, like, hang on for a second, let me go and set these things up and do things. It just works. And we envision the same sort of idea for the HĀLO system. So when I turn it on here, my lovely Larissa here is going to walk around a little bit. You see now it's actually on my screen. She's walking around, and it's tracking her.
Right. And it can see her in 3D space.
Right. So from a manual focusing standpoint, you can see one of the things I can do is just simply keeping track of her is now an incredibly easy thing to do. And as long as she's in my depth of field, even if I'm a little bit off and she's moving back a little bit, or maybe I would say, oh, I'm going to adjust my aperture open a little bit to get a little bit more there, this allows me to actually track her very easily. I can also scrub this. So for example, I don't necessarily need the wheel. I can actually just move it with my finger and track her this way. And weirdly, like the more I use the system, the more I sort of prefer the software interface. It just seems it's easier to do.
Right.
So we're going to go ahead and add a second person in. My buddy Alex is going to walk on, who's not paying attention right now, but here he comes. And now you can see a second person has shown up. And there's a little bit of a glitch there, but now I can actually sort of rack focus between them. And what's really nice here is it's predictive. I can kind of see where they are. I know when I'm pulling a focus, when I'm getting close. So it's not a kind of a guessing game. I'm actually sort of seeing a map of my scene and what's going on.
So in terms of the how big they actually are on this map here,
yeah.
Is this as big as they'll get in terms of? So say I was really shallow, and I actually wanted to be like at the front of this circle because of where they'll be in terms of where the depth of field will be.
Yeah, that's all programmable. I mean, those are the things that you can actually adjust. What we wanted to do was show a very sort of simple example of people and as dots, but you can actually change the shape. You can change kind of how big they are. You can change, like, for example, people were asking about like cars versus people. We can actually have different objects look at different sizes. So you can have a combination of things showing up on the screen, and you'll be able to actually visually tell them apart based upon the icons.
Okay. So and is there a limit to how many right now, or is it?
There's not. I mean, again, you sort of think about typical scenes, right. And that's the kind of scenario we're going to see. And this is just kind of keeping it simple right now. From a manual focus standpoint, as my two buddies here are going to start moving around, we call it HĀLO because HĀLO is a verb. So I'm going to go ahead and HĀLO her. And you can see she's got this bracket now, and we're tracking focus on her. Okay. So now, wherever she's going, she's actually in focus. And I'm going to go ahead and switch to Alex, and he's going to move about. One of the other things that's really cool about HĀLO is this is a 180-degree view in front of the lens. So as Alex walks, and he's actually going to walk out of frame, you see I can still keep track of him in the focus.
It's still seeing him. He's just out of the angle.
So I'm not limited to what that camera sees. I'm actually using this HĀLO system and actually knowing exactly what's going on. We don't want just automated focus, and we don't want just manual focus. We want some sort of ability to move between them, and that's nothing that's really been tried before.
And also, depending on experience, different people want different types of automatic or manual.
Right, so I'm not particularly good at focus, pulling focus, but I'm pretty sure I could focus on the dartboard, especially since it's here. But as she's moving around, just not that good, frankly. So while Larissa's moving around, I still have her haloed, but I can actually go ahead and override this and go ahead and focus on the dartboard, maybe focus on Alex. Oh, I'm sorry, I got Alex haloed. And then when I let go, it will actually go back to her. So I have this combination of kind of moving between manual focus and then autofocus. Right.
That's great. And so then in terms of price and availability on this setup with the control interface and with the device that goes under the camera.
Right. So we're previewing it today. This is like literally within the first 8 hours that anybody's seen this. So the availability we think is going to be later this year. We haven't really finalized the price, but our target, one of the things that we also felt was really important is it's got to be affordable because people need access to it. So we're thinking probably for a solution somewhere in the $2,000 to $5,000 range. And again, there's a lot of pieces. We got to figure out how to bundle them. But compared to other types of approaches, we think it's a tremendously affordable. It can work with any camera, any lens. The range, by the way, is about 100 to 120 feet. So it goes quite a distance out. Works in complete darkness. Can work in bright light. So all of the limitations you hear in other types of approaches are things that we think we've really done a good job overcoming.
Right. And that price will be more of the HĀLO system, and then you'd need your own wireless follow focus system separately from the HĀLO.
Well, it requires some sort of remote focus system to move the focus system. We haven't really decided how much of that's going to be part of that package price or not, but that's our notion, is that price range sort of gets you a solution.
Okay. And now, would this be more of an open system, or this might require your micro remote?
Right. So if the question you're asking is it only work with our stuff? Right. The answer is right now it does, right. But there's nothing unique about what we're doing that would cause it to say, well, it will only work with this in the future. And we sort of have a vision for how that's going to go forward.
Okay. So we're looking at the new firmware 3.0 that just came out for the micro remote.
Right. So the micro remote's been out now for about 2.5 years, 3 years. This is our latest firmware. It is now shipping, and it's available as a free upgrade to current remote customers. And if you buy one today, it's actually going to be what ship with it. I want to show you a couple things about the remote 3.0. First of all, we are now using the flex cables, which are great for any sort of handheld rig, but especially for gimbals. We have a prepackaged solution for Movi and also for the DJI Ronin.
Do you know pricing on those cables?
It depends, like the packages include them, but roughly speaking, they range from about, I'd say it's like $50 up to about $150, depending on the connector and that kind of stuff. So the Artistry is a feature that really is for enthusiasts or kind of beginner folks that adds a little bit of smoothing and a little bit of ramping to focus pulls. It still is incredibly accurate in terms of the marks themselves, but when I'm turning it, you can see that it just adds a little bit of ramping at the beginning and at the end, and then just overall smooths out so it's not getting like the little hiccups that I'm doing here as a non-professional focus puller. So you can actually dial in the amount of Artistry you want. It's not an on or off. You can actually turn it off, or you can actually dial it in about 10-step increments, as much as little as you want.
So this is really like, if you want your focus pulls not to be so hard, this will just smooth them out just a little bit between pulls.
And that goes nicely along with the second part of the 3.0 firmware update, which is we've quadrupled the resolution of our remote focus. So what people are going to find is it's a lot smoother, it's a lot more consistent. It hits marks accurately for a wider range of lenses, so especially folks using long throw lenses, they're just going to be spot on. So we think we have a little bit of something for enthusiasts, we think we have a little bit of something for professionals.
That's great. Thank you.
Cool. Thank you.